السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله هيا للصلاة هيا للصلاة هيا للفلاح هيا للفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
محمد درجة للناس واحدة إنك لا تخفي. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهد الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن سيدنا محمد عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى الصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى سرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أما بعد All praise and thanks are due to Almighty Allah. We glorify Him. We show our God to Him. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his family and his companions to the day of judgment. Almighty Allah has addressed me and you in Al Quran al Azim saying, O you who believe, fear Allah wherever you are. Fear Allah. And do not return to me except you die in the state of Islam. Inshallah, my brothers and sisters in Islam, today's topic is about our iman. How are we gonna upgrade our iman? Then who want to teach us this lesson is one of the Sahaba of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sayyidina Ali karamallahu wajhahu. Because all of the Sahaba, Allah bless them, because they learn a lot from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Out of this, they share with us so that we can learn, so that we can know what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam really wants from us and what Islam really needs from us. Sayyidina Ali karamallahu wajhahu said, "Man jama'a sitta khisal." Whomever that Almighty Allah has given him these six principles that I want to tell about you. Then Sayyidina Ali say, definitely, Almighty Allah will make him closer to Jannah. And Almighty Allah will distance him out of the hellfire. Because he tried all of his best in order to be more closer to Almighty Allah. My brother and sister in Islam, the first thing that Sayyidina Ali mentioned for us, he say, "Man a'arafa Allah fa'atta'ahu." He who amongst you, the follower of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who know about Almighty Allah Himself, then obey Him. First of all, let me clear the first one. There is no way we can see Almighty Allah with naked of our eyes. Definitely. Allah is not like a human being, like us. But what Sayyidina Ali is trying to let us know how is functioning of Almighty Allah. How are we going to give Almighty Allah attention? How are we going to know that Allah is in charge of everything? Once you understand that, you know that, definitely you won't have problem. Your iman will be upgrading. Then, after that, you follow him, you obey him. Because the moment that you identify him like that, then you obey him. When Almighty Allah speak in Al-Quran al-Azim, you follow. This is what Almighty Allah needs from us. But my brother and sister in Islam, in many cases, it's difficult. It's difficult in the sense that we put our interest over the interest of Almighty Allah. Why? Because we want to eat. Why? Because we want to feed our family. Why? Because we desire this life, and so on. But one thing that we have to know, once we understand this, in order to distance ourselves from this, we have to understand that Almighty Allah mentioned one thing, and it's clear to me and you. It's very clear. Almighty Allah says in Al-Quran Al-Azim, remember, وَإِذْ أَنْتُمْ أَجِنَّةٌ فِي بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ. Allahu Akbar. Almighty Allah refer us to that. That if you are busy on what you're going to eat or to feed your family, or something is worrying you about this dunya, so that's the reason why you have more interest than Almighty Allah. Almighty Allah says, what about this? When you are hidden in the womb of your mother, when your mother took you for 9 months, who was feeding you there? Allah. Allah. What about that? You forget? Do you ask Almighty Allah to provide for you at that moment? No. But Almighty Allah knows it's my duty to do that for you. So why you can not have the same hope to Almighty Allah who preserve you from that moment till now, till the time that you can ask Almighty Allah what you desire? Almighty Allah say, I'm in charge, and I will still continue this word of Almighty Allah. Wa is antum ajinnatum fi butuni ummahatikum. Almighty Allah say, don't forget. Get closer to me. To the extent that Almighty Allah says in Hadith al-Qudus, Almighty Allah says, Ya Ibadi, O my servant. Look at the how Almighty Allah tries to call up. Because when Almighty Allah says, Ya Ibadi, Almighty Allah is trying to address all of us. The son of Adam. Because either we like it or not, we are the servant of Almighty Allah. Allah knows. Almighty Allah say, Ya Ibadi, oh my servant, oh my slave, Kullukum dalla illa man hadaita. Each, every one of you is lost, except the one that I guided. I know that. Allah is talking. Then Almighty Allah say, rush to me. Fasa'aluni al-huda ahadikum. Almighty Allah say, come to me. Ask the guidance from me. Then I will guide you. I'm there for you. Many guidance. Where I'm going to get the money? Allah knows better than you. How many times you have already have hope? Maybe to one of your friends or your boss, and they disappointed you. How many times? Maybe by that time, if you wait for the call of Almighty Allah, maybe Almighty Allah will say, okay, go to so person. You may get whatever you want from him or her. All means, let's say, I will guard you. وَقُلْ لَكُمْ فَكِيرُ إِلَّا مَنْ أَدْنَتُهُ. All means, Allah say, each every one of you is poor, except the one that I choose that, I will enrich you. Then all means, Allah say, don't stop, rush to me. فَسَأَلُونِي أَرْزُقُكُمْ. Ask me, I will remove you, or I will remove your poverty for you. All may tell us, address me, how you? Even in time of sin, if we overwhelm our sin with sins, all may tell us, I know that you are sinful. You are a sinner. All may tell us, say that, I know. But wastaghfiruni ghafartu la wala ubali. Seek the forgiveness from him. Then I will forgive you. Even I don't care. I don't care which thing that you have already committed. Only until the moment that you come to me, I will rescue you. Look at the advice of Sayyidina Ali. Karamallahu wajhahu. And Almighty Allah did not leave me and you. In our salat, Almighty Allah still say, Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. Iyyaka na'budu, for the believers, wa iyyaka nasta'in. You do, you worship, and your head, we seek Allah. And the second one, inshallah, today I will mention only three. I'll keep the three for the next time, inshallah, because of the time. And the second one, من عرف الشيطان فعصاه. He who understand about the action of shaitan, devil, فعصاه, and disobey him, that I don't want to listen to you. I don't want to listen to you. Because the only enemy that we have, first enemy, is Shaitan. Allah told us in Al-Quran Al-Azim, don't listen to him. Even وَلَا تَتَّبِي خُطُوَةِ الشَّيْطَانِ. Never go on the step of the shaitan. Don't walk on it. Shaitan going to mislead you. Because he has not promised that mustaqim. He promised Almighty Allah, saying, oh Allah, I will lay ambush for the son of Adam. I will try by all means in order to mislead them out of your way, oh Allah. Then Almighty Allah agreed. Imagine. So that's the reason why we need to be careful. That's why that Almighty Allah counter him later by saying that, okay, when they come back to me, then I will forgive them, the son of Adam. لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله. That's another issue. But Almighty Allah wants us to distance ourselves with Shaitan. Let me give you one example how Shaitan used to deceive us. Because there is no friend that we can be with Shaitan. Believe me, Shaitan is going to disappoint us. It's like antelope, animal, we all know, and monkey, both of them, they are friends. They choose each other as a friend. And the mother of the antelope said to the antelope, please, don't take the monkey as a friend, because that monkey gonna deceive you. But antelope does not listen. Say, no way. I love the monkey, and monkey loves me. So one day, both of them were walking on their way. All of a sudden, both of them see a pit. And the moment that they enter this pit, that's it. Immediately when the monkey saw the pit, monkey flew and he climbed the tree. What of antelope? Antelope entered the pit. This is exactly Shaitan. So now antelope is saying that, save me, save me. And you say, no, I can't. There's no way for me. This is exactly Shaitan. That's this moment. Well, that's the devil. What is Shaitan? Shaitan is going to deceive you. Don't listen. In any sense, don't listen to Shaitan. But out of the mass of Almighty Allah doesn't want us to stay in his trap. Almighty Allah wants us to get out of the track. Then Almighty Allah say, "Wa anibu ila rabbikum waslimu lahu." Almighty Allah, the moment that you are in the trap of the shaitan, "Wa anibu," and you turn back, oh Allah, I'm surrender. Oh Allah, I'm quit. Ila rabbikum, to your Lord. Make repentance to your Lord. Wa aslimu lahu, and surrender yourself to Almighty Allah. Almighty Allah say, then I will take care of you. I will forgive you. I will not let Shaitan take you away from me. Almighty Allah say that. Because that Shaitan, if you want to say that, oh, there's no way for me because I'm a worshiper. What of Shaitan? Remember, Shaitan more worshiper than you. Every time that Shaitan sees us worshiping Almighty Allah, making our sujood, and Shaitan never happy. And we say that, oh, sometimes ago, I've done the same thing now. But for the fact that I did not turn back to Almighty Allah, that's the reason why Almighty Allah caused me. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. This second advice of Sayyidina Ali, karamallahu wajhah. And the third one, man arafa al-haqq fattaba'ahu. Whoever knows the truth, you know the truth. You know the existence of Almighty Allah. You know that Allah is Allah, and you follow, you obey Him. Almighty Allah will love you. Because you have the hope in Almighty Allah. You put all your trust in Almighty Allah. The moment that you recognize Almighty Allah, you say, Allah is true. Because there's no way that we can deny Almighty Allah from what we have been seeing this dunya. Are you going to deny Almighty Allah that Allah does not exist? Almighty Allah said, because the moment that Almighty Allah says something, Allah is going to fulfill it. مِنْ يَخَلَكِنَاكُمْ وَفِيَا نُعِيدُكُمْ وَمِنَا نُخُرِجُكُمْ تَارَةَ نُخُورًا. Almighty Allah has told us already that in this hell, I created your forefather, Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. Then Almighty Allah said, one day you're going to return. And it's happened. No one can deny it. Even though if we did not see the rest, that one told us and tells us that, oh, Allah is existing. Starting from the testification, shahada, believe in Allah, that Allah is one. Believe in Almighty Allah. Inni ashahadu an la ilaha illa anta. Saying that there is no God except Almighty Allah. Testify that Almighty Allah is the one. No one beside you, Allah. Wahadaka la sharika lak. You have no partner. That's part of what Sayyidina Ali wants us to believe. To know that al-haq, Allah, the existence of Almighty Allah. Then, wa anna Muhammadan. Muhammadan, abduk wa rasulik. We have to put it in our mind that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the servant of Almighty Allah and his messenger of Almighty Allah at the same time. Wa ashhadu anna wa'adaka haqqun. And to have in our mind that promise of Almighty Allah is the truth. When Almighty Allah makes his promise, Allah is going to fulfill it. وَلِقَاءَكَ حَقٌّ. And to have in our faith that a day that will meet Almighty Allah is true. مَنْ كَانَ يَرِجُ اللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. مَنْ كَانَ يَرِجُ اللَّهِ. مَنْ كَانَ يَرِجُ اللَّهِ فَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. Almighty Allah say, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ كَانَتْ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتُ الْفِرْدَوْسِ نُزُلًا خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا لَا يَبْغُونَ أَنْ حِوَلًا. قُلْ لَوْ كَانَ الْبَحْرُ مِدَادًا لِكَلِمَةِ رَبِّي لنفد البحر قبل أن تنفد كلمة ربي ولو جينا بمثل مرد. قل إنما أنا بشر مثلكم يوحى إلي أنما إلهكم إلا واحد فمن كان يرجو لقاء ربي فليعمل عملا صالحا ولا يشرك بعبادة ربي أحدا. Almighty want us to have that faith, to have that belief that the moment that we know that we will meet Almighty Allah one day, then let us indulge ourselves in worship Almighty Allah and good deed. Almighty Allah say. Then, wali jannat haqqun. We have to believe that the paradise that Almighty Allah promised true. Wa nar haqqun. And the hellfire is true. Wa anna sa'ata atiyatun la rayba fiha wa annaka tab'ath man fil qubur. Allahu akbar. Wa anna sa'at. And verily, the hours will come. Almighty Allah promised that the hour will come. Allah promised that day of resurrection will come. But one thing has to come before. La rayba fi almighty, no doubt about that. Wa annaka taba'athu man fil kubur. That's Allah. Taba'athu man fil kubur. We raise up all who are in the grave one day. We are accountable for our deed. All of these, we have to believe that. This word, Sayyidina Ali Karam Allah, trying to teach us. In hadith of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, finally, this hadith came from Abi Ayyub al-Ansar. Abi Ayyub al-Ansar, who is Abi Ayyub al-Ansar? One of the one that will receive Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam the moment he got to Medina. Come to my house. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam staying in his house for some time, so that we can know how the closest friend to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, I heard from Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who said, ما من عبد عبد الله لا تشرك به شيئا وأقام الصلاة وآتى الزكاة وصام رمضان واجتنب الكباحر واجتنب الكباحر then witness فله الجنة. الله أكبر. This Ayuba say that I heard from Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, no one in the servant of Almighty Allah who did not associate anything to Almighty Allah and establish his prayer about Siyam, fasting, he come up with